shit. Come on.
Alright, alright, Sway's in the house. That's the UK in the house. We got the club feeling like Oceana. Flick with an empty, we're waving it down. Stop, watch my girl, she's a dancer. Hot like hell, she's the devil in Prada. Now the way the money go, no, no. And she know the way my voice go, no, no. Hands to the sky, reach for the car. Now let me see you pull it down. Hold it down now, dip to the ground now. La 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 la. Hollering at the reels, and pretty women up in here say la 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 la. Holler at me on my email, that's on the internet like la 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 la. Remember to pop a bottle, pop a bottle. Big brother's big mouth makes your first foot the speed of a goal.
Decision to stay strictly dickly forced Shabby to sneak out the back door in search of her magic hat. But that wasn't the big shock of the week. That was when Ben actually completed his first ever task. And the week ended with potty mouth mono Brad Nathan getting the boot as three new housemates landed in the garden. Anyway, let's start by showing our love for tonight's amazing guest. Now, she's got shiny legs. She's part of the Big Mouth family. She's our Netto superstar, Jamelia. And quite brilliantly, he came free with Jamelia. It's comedian Sean Walsh.
Thank you. Thank you.
And you know what? The names weren't down, but he let them in anyway. It's a Big Mouth audience. It suddenly dawns on Kiva that she might have led Shabby on. I wonder what Ben's favourite band is.
I love you too.
Now, what makes the perfect party? Chocolate fountain, vodka luge?
They have a table of hats!
And did anyone else notice that Alice Cooper had gone into the house? Now look, if sitting at home and just watching TV is all just a bit 90s, then why don't you go crazy and get in touch with us by using your computer? So many ways you can. Well, three. Details on your screen now. We'd love to hear from you. And as always, man baby Benjamin Button, a.k.a. Tom Allen, is here waiting for your messages.
Send them in.
Amped tonight.
What, you know what?
Are you amped?
What are you talking about? Of course amped. I'm amped. Yeah, I'm always amped. Aren't we all? Why are we here if we weren't amped? Oh, I don't know what I'm saying.
Okay, so tonight, Tom.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Love you.
I love you too.
Okay, so tonight Nathan became the latest loser when he was told to bog off out of the house. But before we talk about any of that, just two words. Fresh meat! Andrew, who looked like a lamb to the slaughter. Andrew, oh no! I fear for his safety in there. Rachel and Keely, they've just touched down in the house. Sean, what did you make of the newbies?
The newbies? The little sort of Harry Potter one.
Bless him.
Yeah, I think he needs sex.
Yes.
I think they should just shove him in and shag him.
Who?
All of them. It should be a Big Brother gangbang first.
I'd like to see Josie get her hands on.
Yes.
On Andrew.
What he could do is they could blindfold him.
Yes.
And then all jump on him.
Yes.
And then because he's good at maths, he can try and work out how many did him.
Brilliant.
Yes.
Amazing.
Yes.
And he'd enjoy that.
I don't know if he would. I think he'd rather read.
He probably would. Yeah. Jamelia, Are you loving the fresh meat? Do you think it's the right time? Are we happy they've gone in?
I mean, you know, it's always the right time. I think that Big Brother is quite evil, putting them in at this point in time, because obviously a family's already been made within the
it's
house
quite late
already.
On, actually, for Big Brother.
Exactly. But I'm also quite interested to see, you know, Corinne and the new dumb one clash. You know, I'm not saying, no. You know, she's a bit dizzy from the new one. What's her name? Rachel. I'm seeing them clash. You know, they've really got big personalities, and I'm interested to see how the dynamics change in the house with them.
And they've all got it in for Kiva. They all.
Yeah.
Let's talk some more about Andrew, the lamb. Right, I've got some facts for you, okay? So, if he was to go on Britain's Got Talent, he would do live maths.
Oh, Blairs.
Yeah. Yes, that's.
Okay. He does not know what anal bleaching is, but to be honest, I don't know what anal bleaching is.
What is anal bleaching? Can anyone tell me?
But I'm willing to learn.
Hang on. Well, can somebody do it? Well, can anybody please tell me what anal bleaching is?
I really don't.
You do know.
It's where you dye the hair around your anus.
Oh, nice.
Really?
Why not just
what
shave
hair?
The hair?
Anyway.
You.
Right, if he were to bring out an aftershave, he would call it Andrew. Bless him. I know. So, listen, what do we think about Andrew? I'm glad you said that.
He's the Milky Way kid, without a doubt.
It's the first thing.
Absolutely is, yeah.
It's hilarious, isn't
it? I was expecting him to go in and shout the Milky Bars on me.
But you know he's had a life, because he's very, very bright. He did his first A-level at 13, and he's had a life of studying. He's never lived, so I think he's going to live in there.
He looks like Napoleon Dynamite.
Yeah, definitely.
He
definitely.
Really, really does.
He does. He looks like he should be Dave's son or something.
So there you go. That's exactly what he looks
like. So, is he going to be great, or is he going to have a good time?
I think he's going to going to be great, but not for the good reasons. He's going to be great TV, but yeah.
Ben's brother. Yep. He's
going
to be boring.
I think he'll help them. I think he's going to be like the new Joe 90. He's going to be in a bit of a whirl. For those who remember Joe 90.
Yeah. I remember Joe 90. They don't. So let's talk about our next newbie, Rachel. She's been to Morocco for 25 minutes. I don't know why. I don't understand it either. She was sacked. Rachel, this was quite something. Rachel was sacked by Mecca Bingo. You've got to do something. Wow. You've got to do something really bad to be sacked. I've got no idea. I'm going to start digging. She spends most of her money on Primark and alcohol. So it's just like our... just like our studio audience. So, having told you all of that, Sean, impressions?
It sounds to me like she got sacked from Mecca Bingo because Mecca Bingo was taking place in Morocco and she only turned up for 25 minutes.
Yes.
And then left.
That's probably what it is. Tom, could you tell me what people are thinking, what you're thinking?
I'm thinking many things, as always. I particularly love the moment when they all came out of the spaceship and clearly someone had said, right, when you get out of the spaceship, walk like a dickhead, all right? Everybody walk like a dickhead. They're like,
It was embarrassing, wasn't it? It was a
little bit cringeable, but that's why we watched the programme. People on the interweb say, somebody called Bustin Jeeba says...
Oh, that's such a good name!
What a great name. Sounds familiar. Says they're bound to stir things up. As much as I love the original Housemates, I'm so excited for the new ones. Whoop. Love, Charlotte X. Girlbot says, I hope Keely scratches Kiva's eyes out.
She might do. That's what I'm a little bit worried
about. Do you think she's
about.
That type? Do you think she's very aggressive?
Keely?
Yeah.
Yes, I think she's a hard-nosed businesswoman who's got to where she is today by
scratching
stepping
people's
on a few
eyes
heads.
Out. Yeah.
Yeah. Let's talk Keely next. Right. She says she collects gays for a hobby.
She
wants
gays.
To be reincarnated as a terrapin.
Oh. What?
That's weird.
I love terrapins.
And she had her heart broken by a man called Antonio. Of course she did. Antonio. It's just got Heartbreaker written all over it. Yeah. Jamelia, mm-hmm. what do you think of Keely?
I mean, I like her. I think I do see her clashing with Kiva. She's quite a strong character in the house and a strong woman, and I think that she wants to be the alpha female. I think she's going to want to be the alpha female of the house.
She looks deceptively sweet in that picture, but I think she's
going to
be...
I don't think she does.
I think she's going to be on it. Go on, what do you think? I'm here.
I think she's hard. Yeah. She looks a bit like Hayden Panettiere.
Yes, from Heroes.
Yes.
I thought exactly that, but I thought nobody watches it, so they won't know what I'm talking about. But yes, I think. But does anybody think that she's hard in a good way?
No, but
as a housemate,
she looks sweet. I like her,
and she wants to fix things up.
Because we like a bit of hard-nosed housemate, don't we? Come on. Anyway, time for a quick break. We are going to be coming back. With the Sad Tatter Shabby. She's going to be here getting a big mouth roasting, so we're going to see you in a bit. Just there.
It's me, Mario.
I'm hugging him now.
Oh, yeah, you are.
As well, Kirby.
Touch it.
Go on, touch his cock.
Go on. Oh,
boost it.
This is so much fun.
Go on, he loves it.
Just on his bum?
Yeah. Give it a good slap. We should do this all the time.
Oh, we get them both at the same time.
Eva and Josie. Yes. Eva and Josie.
Oh, I feel really pervy. That would be amazing.
Just
it's difficult.
Just
yeah,
no. Text me.
Seriously, how much fun are we having?
Walker Jamelia. Yeah! He's funny, he's cute, he's a BB Santa boot, Sean Walsh. Yeah! Metro textual man of words. Tom Allen. Yeah! And of course our just far too sexy audience. Yeah! But first up, anyone fancy an omelette?
Yeah! God! Come on, you bugger! Who's your daddy?
Have you heard they're remaking Wonder Woman? I wouldn't bother, it looks shit.
Shimmy, 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 pow!
And did anyone else notice Pete Bennett has sneaked back into the house?
Fucking wanker! Wanker! Wanker!
So let's see how all that fresh meat is getting on in there. Andrew, it seems, has settled in well.
Can you believe it? Like, tomorrow you're going to be out in the pool.
Thank you so much. Thank you. God. I can't believe it.
Can you believe it? No. Like, you'll be eating your cereal there in the morning.
It's weird. It's so weird.
I was making me laugh. Can you believe it?
No.
Like, can you believe it? She loves it. She loves it. Can she believe it? No? She's buzzing. Now, Big Brother is the ultimate reality show, or so you think. The disgusting truth is that it's about as real as if he's here. Let's take a look at how the show really gets made.
Okay, now say the next line like you are incredibly constipated. Yeah, it's good. For the last 10 years, people have believed that Big Brother is reality television at its finest. Well, it's not.
Fucking hats!
Oh, for God's sake. Well, you know, see, personally, I don't see how anyone would believe you'll get that angry about a hat. But it seems to have worked. Let's go with it. A couple more scenes, yeah. This is television. All of the classic moments that you love and see have been meticulously planned by me. Dale Pajoshing. All the romance.
And next.
All the accidents. All the arguments.
Shut you fucking up, Shabby, yeah?
Fuck off, Nathan!
All the joy.
Come down a burger! Pull up out, Nathan!
You see, none of that was natural. That was all performance.
I'm sure that person isn't a happy Big Brother, but put yourself in my shoes, you know? I went in...
You don't fuck with me, okay? Okay, one phone call, yeah? One phone call. I have Brian Bello in that garden riding you around like a donkey on your Blackpool seaside, okay? Yeah. So every single word of every single day is written by one man, a genius. Zach has written every series since the first, and he lives in here. Hey, Zach. There you go, buddy. There you go. Okay, 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 okay. This is for tomorrow. No, you have to wait. Okay, so now you know that Big Brother isn't reality TV. It's probably the best drama you've ever seen. Yeah, he's got out again. Use the rubber bullets if you have to.
And just want to say big love to the Rocket Sausage Boys for that. Okay, the time has arrived. She never saw Kiva's beaver. But she has got a magic hat. Give it up for Shammy! Now, Shabby, I know I've sort of touched on this a little bit earlier on, but I am much disappointed that you walked. And in my book, that's on Twitter. Why did you do it?
Why?
Well, I was very upset. I don't know. I was very upset. I was freaking out. And I made a heinous mistake.
He
at the moment, yeah.
And how long did it take you before you realised that you'd made a huge mistake?
About 20 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
That quick?
Oh, yeah, that's got to be the quickest time ever. Like, usually it takes people a day, a week. No, literally, I pretty much came out and regretted it.
I get the impression...
Because I calmed down. I calmed down, yeah. As I do when I'm freaking. And, yeah.
It's a bit like when you smash a glass out of rage and then you have to pick it up. And it's
Well, I couldn't pick it up. I had no dustpan and brush. Yeah, that's the thing. It's a problem.
Jamila, do you want to ask Shabby something?
Sorry, Mike.
You're gorgeous.
Okay.
You carry on there.
Say thank you. Take it on
thank
board.
Thank you very much.
Right? She's gone all funny now. Jamelia, focus.
This question is very superficial, but how much would you sell your hat for?
I honestly wouldn't sell it.
No.
I wouldn't sell it. No. Like, really, after making that much of a fool out of myself regarding a hat, right, really, to go and sell it would just be, you know, I couldn't do it. Yeah, it's priceless.
Okay. Even for £1 million, Shabby, you could buy a house.
Oh, right, maybe for £1 million, we might be able to talk about it. Yeah.
Have you got £1 million?
No. Not yet, but I'm saving.
Not yet.
And then I'm going to get some proper
Sean.
Hat.
Can I just say first,
yes.
I wasn't that bloke sitting in the disabled toilet writing. Just want to point that out. And I've got a question. You said that you were excellent at a cunnilingus. Do you remember this? Have you had a chance to practice since you've been out?
Did I say that?
Yes. Yes.
Don't worry, John James, I haven't. For late.
Like, I've come out, there have been some offers. but you know, I'm not going to say that I've fallen in love with somebody 1 minute and then go and start, you know, the next.
What's that? Do that again? Right, that's nice. Where are the offers from?
Audience, who wants to ask Shabby a question? Hang on, I'm coming round. And while we're here, you can have a quick grope of my bum.
Do you...
They've been asking all evening.
Hang on,
let me firm.
There, now ask. Do you base your image on the Artful Dodger from Oliver?
Yes.
I'd do anything
for you.
Stop! We've got to pay them! Stop singing!
Anything for you!
Stop, it's awful. Oh!
Did you go to private school?
No. I went to the same school as Iffy.
Did you?
Yes.
Did you?
Yeah.
How weird is that?
But we didn't know that till we were in the house.
Did you bully her there?
Did I bully her there?
Yeah.
We're going to have to agree to disagree on that one because I don't think there was a lot that Iffy said to me that wasn't shown. So.
Ooh.
many hens do you have?
Lots.
How many? About, is that in the house? 20, you're talking hats. About whether Iffy gave you a hard time and you gave Iffy a hard time
it
in
was,
the house.
It was pretty mutual, yeah, in the house.
Yeah.
So there was no love lost there in the end?
No.
Did you have a... You had a question, didn't you?
You're an actress, so you know what it's like to be fake. Do you think anybody else is putting on an act in the house?
I think... Mario. I think Mario's putting on an act.
Really? Why?
Because he had this whole nice guy thing going on, and he's actually not... He's quite a spiteful, catty little guy, actually. Yeah. I mean, him and Ben, really good friends, so why is he saying stuff? He suddenly switched on Ben.
He did switch on Ben, but I think he was upset that Ben didn't like him.
Yeah, but, you
well,
know,
you
I was upset Kiva didn't like
out.
Me.
Because I know that Corinne... I know that Corinne was sort of on your list of fakers.
Not my list.
No. Kiva's.
That was Kiva's,
John
yeah.
James. What do you think?
I completely disagree with them. I told Kiva that in the house. Corinne is completely herself. Yeah. Just because she does have a bit of a temper inside, I think that she hasn't let out too much. But that's not her faking it. That's her just going, you know what, I get annoyed sometimes, then I calm down. Corinne is 100% real.
Yeah.
100%.
Sorry, Tom.
Yes. Oh, so many people saying different things. I mean, it's fascinating because when you're in the house, I found I was getting quite frustrated with you at different times. But now I see you're actually very genuine. I think that's what's quite... That's why you're a brilliant housemate. And I'm sure whoever you live with next will agree. And somebody called Simon... Well, OK, Gay So What says, ask Scabby why she walked and if she now regrets it. I fucking loved her. So they call you Scabby on one hand, then they ask you why you left.
Yeah, well, I quite like this whole Scabby catch a goo-goo thing. Scabby walked because Scabby was freaking and Scabby regrets it.
OK, yeah. OK. Simon Oggy says, Shabby's on Big Mouth tonight too. Really? Might give it a miss then. She's a quitter and a child. Soz. No. Then they say Soz afterwards. People are very mixed about you, though, Shabby.
I must say that if it hadn't been the last series, I would also be upset, even though I think you're a great housemate and I really like you. I would also be upset that Shabby was getting so much attention because it would then let people think, well, if I leave, I'll still get my interview and my best bits.
But
because
the
it's the last
know.
Series, they don't know and they'll never know because there won't be another series. Okay, everybody loves a double act. Rihanna, Jay-Z, Kylie, Jason, Shakademus, Pliers, all great. But they're not even fit to lick the stilettos of these two. Check this out!
Hello, hello, baby, you called, I can't hear a thing. I have got no service in the club, you say. What did you say? Oh, you're breaking up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you, I'm kind of busy.
see that video again and again and again, check out the website, channel4.com/Big Brother. Right, time now for another quick break, but when we come back, the monobrowed little chef. Sunshine, this has, like, made your life, hasn't it? But she's still like that. The monobrowed little chef, Nathan, will be going under the Big Mouth grill. I'll see you shortly. Jamelia! Mercury Comedian of the Year, Sean Walsh! I've got a silly name, I just don't care, it's Shabby. It's the delicious Tom Allen. And of course, our mother funky audience! Now, UK, understand what's about to go down. Straight from the car wash, this shit is clean. It's Westwood and his mad crazy clip of the week!
Please come to the diary room. We're riding big with Westwood's clip of the week. Let's go in.
I've just been eating a carrot.
Go hard or go home.
Okay, he's got attitude. He's got vests. He's got rid of his lesbian pests. It's Nathan! Nathan's eyeing up Rachel already. He's like that. All right. I've got so many questions. So many questions for you, Nathan. But Sean, what would you like to know?
I was wondering, just as a favour. Yes. Me. Could you donate some of your eyebrow to Tom?
I've got it.
Okay. Yeah.
That's something.
Yes.
Isn't it? Jamelia, what would you like to ask?
I would like to ask you, do you kiss your mother with that mouth?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah?
On my cheek, though. I'm quite infectious.
But do you know what I was quite impressed with? Because I know how you like to swear. And during our interview earlier on, you were so good. Was it
honestly,
hard?
The bubbling up inside me out there. It's all right,
you can cuss on this show, it's fine. But as long as you don't say the C word.
What, cooking?
Yes, cooking, that's fine. Tom.
Hello. Well, Nathan, you're much more handsome in the flesh.
Yes, thank you very much, Tom.
A lot of people say that.
Yeah. Tom Allen, high five me.
No! people on the information superhighway say things like, Amanda 742 says, I think Nathan looks just like Zoe Ball. I like it, but it is true.
What? I think you might have seen me sitting down to piss
that's
a couple of times.
I thought that too. Maybe we all like that. Somebody called Cool and Breezy says, Nathan loves cooking, funny, good looking, and speaks his mind. Yeah. The perfect man. The perfect man, people say.
So, audience, let me just bring the microphone over to you. Who'd like to ask Nathan a question? Yes.
Nathan, thought you were really, really good in the house. Really liked the fact that you were cooking and stuff and everything. But do you think that now you've come out and you look back on maybe your behaviour in there, that you might have bullied a few people?
Let Nathan answer.
I didn't bully anyone. Not that I can see. That's obviously open to a...
Shabby, you were sort of looking up over there like you wanted to
I was
say
just looking. I was just looking at the ceiling.
Did you feel like it was bullying, or did you just think it was an argument? I mean, there is, you've got to sort of draw the line between having an argument with somebody and being bullied. What did you think?
What are you talking about, the rain cloud incident? No, you know what? I completely agree with you. I'm a proper little rain cloud, thundercloud of doom. I know.
Honest.
But
It was slightly the way you sauntered towards me, which was my issue with it. It was reasonably aggressive, to be honest.
Reasonably aggressive?
No, go on. What did you say to that?
Basically, I could just see a little mouth opening. I thought, no, I'm just going to shut it down. Just stop it now. Because I can't be out hearing anymore.
But we're applauding that. But we mustn't forget that Shelby did feel threatened by that. And it was, and it's not so much what you say. It's walking towards somebody when, you know, you're a woman and stuff. So I can sort of see both sides of it.
I'm sorry.
A couple more questions from the audience. Yes.
Whichever you agree that sometimes you were a bit intimidating. I guess like with Dave as well, behind his back, there were some issues like you'd have
with
Dave.
This is a friend of Dave,
yeah.
By the way.
Yeah. I'm just wondering, the mad monk.
Yeah, I'm just wondering actually whether you've, like, perhaps your horizons have been widened a little bit since you
I think, you know what, I've looked back at a little bit of it and stuff, and you know what, some of my behaviour absolutely appalls me, but some of my behaviour I thought was reasonably genuine and loyal.
It does hold up all your behaviour, good and bad, like a mirror all right into your face, and you have to, you know, that's not easy at all on that journey in there. Listen, Nathan, you're looking sharp.
Really?
Yeah, you're
feeling
lovely.
Tired, Matt, to be fair.
We've got a little surprise for you. Could you just come join me down here, please? Now, there is somebody in the audience who can wait for you to get out of that house.
Sunshine,
she's here
I'm not
now,
cooking.
And she's dying to talk to you. So could you dim the lights, please? And cue the music.
When I left the house, I really, really missed you, like, loads.
Cheers, darling.
And I didn't get the chance to tell you in the house that, how much I really liked you. And so I'm telling you now that I really like you.
Yeah.
And I wondered maybe...
I'll marry you tomorrow.
Oh, well, I was just going to say, like...
Yes! 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 Yes!
Lovely.
You're like mother spitting on a tissue.
Yeah, I was just about to, but I thought, no, don't do it. He won't like it. So seriously though, guys, well, maybe a drink just, or something.
Yeah, okay,
are you serious?
Yeah.
You are.
Yeah, I'm
I'll
sorry.
Take okay. Field, yeah.
Listen, moving on. We've got a big. Bit of big mouth exclusive for you here. Channel 4 Comedy Bosses have been blown away by one of the housemates' natural comic flair and have given him his own series. Here's a sneaky peek from the first episode.
I remember one time, it was really funny. I was in London, down here, Roehampton, and I was on the dinner break. I was in this crappy NHS wheelchair going down this road, and I went fucking flying out! Yeah, flying out on the floor like a fucking egg, rolling down the path with this fucking gob lying everywhere. No fucker else. Bit of funny, I was laughing my fucking head off.
About Steve, funny guy. Is he the life and soul, or is he basically a bit of a dullard? What do we really think, Sean? Good.
He does nothing. But I mean, the thing is, I don't want to say anything too bad because he's, you know.
But is this?
He's good. You've got to be careful, haven't you?
But is this the problem? Do you think that people in the house wouldn't nominate him because, you know, I mean, the snoring, somebody did say that was a very good reason to nominate him. It's driving everybody...
Dave is blowing some serious sound out. I'm telling you.
Is it
both ends, it's equally trumpet.
Is it that constant snoring, or is it the worst one, where you just go, and then 2 minutes later you hear another...
The constant snoring, you get used to it. It's you know, the intermittent grunts.
Yeah. Because you just lie there going, he's going to do it again, he's going to do it again.
What do you think about Steve? Is he doing enough?
I do think that maybe he's not, you know, the brightest of stars in the house, but at the same time, I don't think being boring is an offence yet. You know what I mean? He's not being extremely...
It is in Big Brother.
I know, but I don't think it's enough of a reason for them to nominate him. You know, if there are people who are irritating or argumentative or whatever, there are other reasons to nominate people.
Did you manage to catch tonight's show?
Yeah.
Earlier on?
Yeah.
Actually, I thought Steve had his best show yet.
Yeah.
You know, all that stuff with the robot was hilarious. He was absolutely brilliant in that.
Every second of it.
Yeah, no, he was, I mean, he's good, but we need a bit more from him, I think. Do you think he can deliver?
He's a stand-up guy, isn't he? He's a squaddy. You know what I mean? A lot of people don't understand his
humour. But we love that with our task and everything. Squaddy dinner task, perfect. Tom?
I mean, I think he's lovely, and I think that Big Brother really does well with that older person in it as well. Like, I think that's interesting. Like, do you call him granddad or do you call him dad?
Dad,
that's right. Good call him, dad, granddad. And I'm sure, like, he's such a great guy and he's so confident and he's really inspiring, but he certainly doesn't want to be patronised and given kind of special treatment because of his experience. You know, so, well, here's an interesting one. People on the interweb say, someone called Kranatoko says, he's very simplistic, he's very dull and doesn't like to take any nonsense. I wonder why he's in the house. He does naught. I don't know if it's naught or nout.
I don't think that's fair.
Well, that's what Kranatoko says. And then someone called Wormholer693 says, Steve's a war hero. Live feed viewers see he's great in the house. Go, Steve. And I think there's something interesting about the live feed, because a lot of the time we just watch the show at the end of the day, and I think there's stuff going on that we don't
watch. And actually, I've subscribed to the live feed, and it is worth the £14 that you pay. It's worth every single penny, because you do get to see those little bits of housemates that you don't get to see. You know, in an hour show every day, they're going to miss out bits of your personalities.
Would you say that's
I was wrongly edited.
They get a bit more of my swearing in that show.
Yeah, exactly. OK, one last break now, but we've got plenty more shizzles to come, so I'll see you in a bit.
Well, me and my wife first met when we was at primary school, and I didn't like her. She was my eldest sister's friend, best friend, and we always had to go to her house before we went to school. She made me a sandwich. It's got all fucking pink on it. And all mold on it. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Bit of funny. I was laughing my fucking head off.
Big Mouth still with us tonight. We've got Jamelia, Sean Walsh, Shabby, Nathan and Tom Allen, and this bunch of Now, there's a housemate who's above the law, who answers to a different set of rules. His faith has been tested, his hair's been cut off by a toff, but somehow he's got through it all.
Sent by God to live amongst us! Teach.
I believe Hitler was possessed by a supernatural entity that was using him to kill millions of innocent people.
To heal!
I'm going to lay my hands on your nubs. Am I going to command them to grow? Is that all right with you?
To sacrifice!
Dave's literally always picking up the pieces for Ben.
Ben!
Hell of a lot more of a man than that fella just walked out here.
To get shit-faced on the Lord!
I am very, very intoxicated right now on the love of our Lord.
Living in a house of sin. Temptation. Betrayal.
My first nomination is going to be Dave.
The same-sex marriages, that really annoyed me. I think that's such a dated view.
There's only so much preaching you can listen to.
Faith.
How can you read that fucking shit? That doesn't make sense.
Will.
You're bringing religion into it again.
An issue regarding religion. I understand that.
Testing!
I am hammered drunk right now.
Let's talk about Wavy Davey, Mullered on the Holy Spirit. Little fact for you, Dave got no nominations this week. Now, how has he's done that? Jamelia, can you please explain to me what is going on in there?
I mean, I can't personally explain. I must say, I'm in favour of Dave. I love him. I think he's a great character. And also, yeah, I understand that I'm not in the house with him and he's preaching and stuff like that, but he's in the Big Brother house. He doesn't have the the luxury of being able to choose the people who he's around. So if he wants to preach, that's his passion.
But
I don't see anything wrong with it.
He was up for eviction last week and he got no nominations this week. Sean, how did he do that?
I know how he did this because, and I can't believe no one's pointed out, he is clearly Michael McIntyre if he worked in a video shop. Look at him.
Yeah.
I can imagine a week before this ends, he's going to put on a blazer and a pink shirt and go, the thing with Big Brother is, and then, you know, you walk into the dining room, you have to do the thing, Nathan starts cooking. It's McIntyre, look at him.
Shabby, what's he like to live with? Because you know him.
I wasn't the biggest Dave fan at first. The preaching did get a bit much, the immoral gay marriage thing. But actually, he was really, really good to me in the last few days, and I started forming a friendship a little too late, unfortunately. But he's actually a proper nice guy.
So I know there's some guys over here. What about you? Because you're sat behind Dave's friends over here, so yeah. Be careful what you say.
Oh, yes, yes.
Did you like him?
I do like Dave. I think he's a great guy. cool. You know, me and Vinny were talking about it. And the fact that, you know, like, just down to cutting his hair, because these guys were saying how much he loves his hair, and for him to just cut his hair off
so
just like that.
So it's a bit of a Samson moment for him to cut his hair off.
He's not losing his strength. He's doing well in here, old Dave. He's a bit, like, sacrificial. He's got a lot of love to give. And, you know, when he... I'm sure, like, you
are
know...
Are you
when
Dave's brother?
Yeah, I'm Dave's brother.
Like,
there's another
Dave.
Brother of mine, yeah.
You look just like him, and you sound just like him.
Okay. Is that the slosh? We do the slosh fest and all that, and I do the DJ in there. We spend a lot of time getting whacked, like, together.
So him cutting his hair off was a big deal?
It was a very big deal.
I've got to say, you don't want to open a can of worms. He comes across as a bit homophobic television.
Hypocritical. No, but I think that the problem is that he compared
gay people last night
to witches, warlocks, and other crazy people.
I know,
it doesn't do him any favours, but I don't think he's coming from a bad place. You know what I mean, don't you? Tom?
I think what's really interesting about him and, like, a lot of Big Brother is when it shows up the grey area, because we can't go, oh, you know, I don't think he hates gay people.
No.
But it's that great, I don't really understand him.
But I did think that when he said, you know, gay people like witches and warlocks.
Yeah. And I
was like,
as a gay man.
Well, gay people aren't really like witches and warlocks.
Yeah, absolutely. It is. Well, and that's very much been the feeling on the internet. Louise JX says, he doesn't agree with gay marriage, but is constantly touchy-feely with Ben.
Yes.
Right. Which you can see is true, but what do you say about
him? Personally, do you like him?
Good question. I think I could talk to him. I don't think I'd sleep with him. which says a lot for me, Davina.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Yes, go on.
I can say one thing for Dave. There's, like, you know, I mean, there's only one thing that'll touch his backside, and that's a bar of soap. And he loves people, whoever they are, gay or not gay. And I mean, that guy's got, like, opinion. Like, we all... Wait a minute. I mean, we all... Like, opinions are like assholes. We all got one. You just got a big one there. You need to get your facts right, God. Because there's no way that guy is homophobic. He loves, okay?
It is how he comes across. Because he does have to sort of maybe choose his words a bit more carefully or be a bit more sensitive. Because he's a sensitive guy, but it's coming across wrong.
Yeah, prefer one or two comments.
Nathan, did you like him?
I didn't at first, but then I love the guy. It's like watching a 24-hour sitcom with them two going off.
But what made you change your mind?
Just getting to know him, giving him a chance. And I found him to be a warm, loving guy that I wanted to spend more and more time with. That's my biggest regret, not getting to know them two first.
But I think Who here believes that Dave could be a winner?
No! Go on.
Yeah. I think it's taken a few weeks to get to know him, and I think I think Kiva's been pushing him and pushing him recently with the religion thing, like a dog with a bone. She won't let go of it. If, you know, he hasn't pushed his religion onto people.
He has a little bit.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I don't think
he has a little bit. Go on, Nathan.
If you know,
I've got to go. That's all we've got time for. Massive thanks to our big mouth guests, Jamelia, Sean, Tom, and of course Nathan and Shabby, our brilliant Gaga and Beyonce, plus our sexy studio audience, to play us out. It's Sway. See you next time.
Yeah, let's go, Ollie, 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 hey, hey, hey. Let's go, Ollie, 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 let's go, Coca-Cola bottle shake, girl, Coca-Cola bottle shake, I wanna Coca-Cola bottle shake, girl, Coca-Cola bottle shake, I wanna bottle shake, I need a bottle shape. I want a Coca-Cola bottle shape. I want a Coca-Cola bottle shape. Alright, alright. Sway's in the house. That's the UK in the house. Got the flow
feeling like Oceana. Liquid and envy, we're raving it down. Stop. Watch my girl, she's a dancer. Hot like hell, she's a Neverland prancer. Love the way the woman go, no, no. And she like the way my body go, no, no. Hands to the sky, reach for the cloud. Pull it, now I wanna see you pull it. Hold it down, now dip to the ground. Like la 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 la. For the runners and the females and pretty women up in there sing la 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 la. You can catch me on the email. I saw the internet la 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 la. Remember to pop a bottle, bottle. Pop a bottle for me. For pop a bottle, bottle. Pop a bottle with me, come pop a bottle, bottle. Pop a bottle with me, come pop a bottle, bottle. Yeah, yeah, she got a Coca-Cola bottle shake. Coca-Cola bottle shake. She got a Coca-Cola bottle shake. Coca-Cola bottle shake. I need a bottle shake. I need a bottle shake. She got a Coca-Cola bottle shake. Got a Coca-Cola bottle shake. Alright, alright, so he's at the bar. That's the champagne at the bar. Got the cup feeling like smash my whole campaign at the bar. Stop. See that pretty thing walk past. Body like a butter, I'ma put it on the floor. Not the way the body go, no, no. And she not the way my voice go, no, no. Hands to the sky, reach for the clouds. Pull it, yeah, I wanna see you pull it down. Hold it down, now dip to the ground. Like la 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 la. Holler in under the females and pretty women over there sing la 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 la. You can holler from the email. I saw the internet like la 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 la. Let's go.